hackers affiliated with China's People's Liberation Army have infiltrated critical services here in the U.S.
Alexandra Hoff joins us now from our nation's capital. Alex, this is not good.
No, it's not. I mean, this infiltration appears to be part of a broader effort to insert chaos into our logistical systems. The information collected could then be weaponized if the U.S. and China were to become engaged directly in the Pacific. According to reporting from the Washington Post, citing multiple U.S. and industry security officials, China's cyber army is invading critical U.S. services, like an attempt to break into the system behind Texas's independent power grid. Other victims include a water utility in Hawaii, a West Coast port, and at least one oil and gas pipeline, according to that report you're seeing there. Brendan Wells, executive director of the Department of Homeland Security Cybersecurity Agency, told the Washington Post this, quote, "It is very clear that Chinese attempts to compromise critical infrastructure are in part to pre-position themselves to be able to disrupt or destroy that critical infrastructure in the event of a conflict, to either prevent the United States from being able to project power into Asia or to cause societal chaos inside the United States to affect our decision-making around a crisis." The report notes that over the past year, hackers affiliated with the People's Liberation Army in China have accessed the computer systems of about 24 critical entities.
All right. Well, there you go. So that was the Fox News alert today, this morning, right after the premiere Friday night of the movie by Michelle and Barack Obama. Now, what are the odds of that? Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, the movie is called Leave the World Behind. There's multiple trailers they have out there for it, but let me play one of the trailers for you, because guess what the movie is about? It's about a massive cyber attack, but it's more than that, and you don't pick it up on every one of the trailers. The original trailer we played for you guys, what, a month or two ago? We played this month or two ago and said, this is coming. Look out. What are they doing? Predictive programming, but I haven't forgotten. I'm also going to tell you about what I think they're also doing, which I think has to do with the law of attraction. Why is it that they like to tell us in advance what it is they're going to do? I think there's a few reasons. I'm going to tell you why in just a moment. But first, if you don't know about this Barack Obama produced movie, watch the trailer.
So sorry to bother you. You must be Amanda.
Why did you come here?
In my line of work, you have to understand the patterns that govern the world. It can help you see the future. And I knew something was coming.
I don't understand. What do you mean?
We are seeing ongoing cyber attacks across the country.
The truth is much scarier.
What is the truth?
We're gonna be okay, right?
Aren't you the one who always said, if you're not paranoid by now, it's too late?
Haven't you been picking up on what's going on out there? We've all been deserted. There is no going back to normal.
And of course, now it's on Netflix. There's no going back to normal. That's just one of the things you might want to have picked up on there. But oh, my friends, there is so much more. There is so much more, and we will get to it in due time tonight. So we have this text, this breaking news alert that goes out by Fox News the weekend after the premiere of a movie by the Obamas that's all about a cyber attack. Now, why do they do this before we bring our panel on? I think there's a few reasons they do this. One is I think they want us to know that's how in charge they really are. They can tell us in advance what's going to happen. And the things they used to keep hush-hush, they now don't have to because they are so far down the line. And they want us to know in advance. So when it happens, it only makes us more afraid of them. You see, the fear of this shadowy group that runs the world that has so much power. The things that they do, they actually tell us in advance, and then they happen. What a powerful group. And it makes us more afraid of the group, the globalists, the deep state, whatever you want to call them. So it's about their pride. It's about showing off their so-called power. It's about intimidation. It's about fear. You've already lost. You might as well surrender. That's what they want you to believe. You've already lost. We've already won. I think that's part of their goal. Another reason they do this is because they believe in something, and this, of course, the initial description is part of the predictive programming. The predictive programming. You get used to the idea of what's about to happen because when it happens, you're like, yeah, they told us this was going to happen. And the population is kind of conditioned. And as I said, that brings and empowers them more because they had the power to actually know and cause or allow to happen what was going to happen. And now we fear them more because look how powerful they are. The second thing is this, what is known as the law of attraction. I think the law of attraction comes into this. Maybe you're not familiar with the law of attraction. I wrote about it in, I think it was my book, The Coming Religious Reich. It could have been Religious Trojan Horse. In fact, I think it was Religious Trojan Horse. But I wrote about it in that book, 2011, I think Religious Trojan Horse. If it wasn't, it was the one in 2015, but I think it was the 2011 one. And Oprah Winfrey has promoted the idea about the law of attraction. She's interviewed the author. She's promoted this idea. It's an idea that's very popular within the New Age movement, what is also known as cosmic humanism or the New Age movement. The New Age movement, think Oprah Winfrey, Shirley MacLaine, David Spangler, Alice Bailey, Helen Schuckman. These are all major names. Of course, Alice Bailey, Helen Schuckman are some of the most popular names. Alice Bailey, many would consider her to be the mother of the New Age movement. Helen Schuckman channeled what is considered the Bible of the New Age, A Course in Miracles, that Oprah Winfrey and one of her guests taught on XM Radio many years ago. That's the New Age movement, cosmic humanism. And part of this idea is the law of attraction. It is the idea that your mind has power over reality. Your mind has power over matter. The mind over matter. The mind can control and bring things into being through the power of the mind. And this can happen with positive thought or negative thought. Have you ever heard someone say, oh, don't say that. I don't want to see that negative thought become a reality. Well, they're really buying into the idea, whether they know it or not, that your thoughts, the power of your mind, positive or negative, can create reality. It's made its way into the modern day Protestant churches known as the prosperity gospel, or name it and claim it. Name it and claim it. The power of the mind. It really dates back to Norman Vincent Peale, the power of positive thinking, the power of positive thinking. Norman Vincent Peale. Was this who influenced Robert Schuller of the Crystal Cathedral, who went on to influence many people, including Rick Warren. So there's the power of the mind, and yet many within the so-called Christian Protestant world have embraced these ideas and mainstreamed what is nothing more than really occultism, which is white magic. Black magic is openly and overtly evil, and apparently so. It's obvious. It's black magic. White magic is evil wrapped in a lure or a camouflage of white, of goodness, like a good witch and a bad witch. I think probably one of the first times you ever saw this thesis and antithesis with a good witch and a bad witch was probably the Wizard of Oz. White magic is really the same occultism of black magic, but it's wrapped in a package of appearing to be good. White magic. And this is really what goes on in much of so-called Christianity today. Occultism has been camouflaged to be good, and now instead of calling it what it really is, shamanism. What many shaman practice and have practiced for centuries in the occult in tribes and villages of Indonesia and other nations, those now have been wrapped and are in the Christian, so-called Christian world. But it's not called shamanism. It's called now the power of positive thinking. Name it and claim it. The prosperity gospel. So I want to be very clear. I want to be very fair. This occultism has taken shifts and forms, and it is moved among our culture and the various power centers of our culture, from business to so-called Protestant conservative Christianity, or conservatives sadly are practicing this. But it's called the power of the mind, the mind over matter. Now, the law of attraction. This can be for the good or for evil. For good or for evil. You think a negative thought, you better be careful. That might come to pass. That's what you hear people talk about. Oh, don't speak that. Don't speak that into reality. So why would the elite want to talk to us in advance and tell us in advance about so many of these things? I believe it comes down to the idea of the law of attraction, in part. You ever heard the term harmonic convergence? Harmonic convergence. Have you ever seen a bumper sticker? Some of you older folks in the audience, like myself and older, you ever seen a bumper sticker back in the day? Visualize world peace. Visualize world peace. Maybe some of those that are younger in the audience don't really know what I'm talking about, but that was a popular bumper sticker back in the 80s for sure. Visualize world peace. What's that about? That's the idea of a harmonic convergence. If we can get people to come together, kind of like that song, We Are the World, which, by the way, Michael Jackson wrote that along with Lionel Richie, and Michael Jackson talked about, you know, how he wrote some of his music and the realm from which some of his music came. And it wasn't the Christian realm. Harmonic convergence is the idea of the power of the mind collectively to change reality and bring about a new world, a new order. And if we could just get all of us to come together with the power of our mind and visualize world peace, visualize unity, visualize good things on our way to the new order, Alice Bailey, occultist, which they get the term new world order, the new order, if we could use the power of our mind collectively, then we could change the world. Kind of like John Lennon's song, Imagine. We could just all imagine there's no war. The power of the mind over matter. This is what the occult teaches. This is what New Age followers teach. This is even, as I said, in so-called Christianity, the law of attraction. So when they put out things in advance and we think about them and we talk about them, and whether you are for them or whether you fear them, you are, in their idea, in the law of attraction, you are sending out a signal. You're sending out energy. And when, have you ever heard someone say, we're sending out good energy your way? As Christians, we would say, we're praying for them. That's completely different. We're praying for them. We're praying that God's will be done, right? We're praying that God will intervene here. But whatever it is, we're praying His will be done, not ours, right? That's different than someone who may say, well, we're sending out positive energy to them. Well, maybe they don't know what they're really saying, but what they're saying is there is a belief system that says if enough people concentrate on something, send out a positive thought or even a negative thought, it doesn't really matter. If there are thoughts going out, whether positive or negative, those thoughts meet up with other people's thoughts and it can create something. Enough people think good thoughts and visualize world peace might become a reality. If enough people are thinking negatively and bad, those thoughts, those energies find each other, and those can manifest into negative things that can occur. This is what is called the law of attraction. What you think about is what you're attracting. This is the idea. It's shamanism. Again, it's practiced in the occult. So when the globalists, many of them who are into Satanism, occultism, New Age, cosmic humanism, when they talk about these things in advance, when they put it into the culture, when they put it into films and books and symposiums and papers and articles, I believe, having studied these people now for 33 years, they believe that even our thinking about it, of being against it, is helping to further the goal of us talking about it and sending energies out into the world that meet up with other people's thoughts and energies and will then bring this to pass. It's called the law of attraction. And in their mind, they're talking about there being chaos. And out of this chaos, what do they see coming? Well, if you study the occult, they believe that out of all of this chaos is going to come a world leader, the Maitreya. You could call him the Maitreya. You could call him the Christ. You could call him a lot of things. There are a lot of names that different religions use. In the Bible, it's referred to as the Antichrist. He is referred to as the son of perdition, the Antichrist, the one of lawlessness. Isn't that interesting? The Bible says there's going to rise up a world leader known as the Antichrist who will oversee a one-world government, a one-world economy, and a one-world religion. And the Bible says that's going to happen. The New Agers are waiting on a world leader that will usher in the New World Order, or the New Order, depending on who you're talking to. And he will oversee a world government and a world religion, just like the Bible says is coming. Now, isn't that interesting? You see, the Bible is predictive prophecy. It's telling us in advance what's going to happen. In fact, Jesus said to his disciples in Matthew chapter 24, I tell you these things are going to happen, so you will not fear. But predictive prophecy in the Bible also reveals the supernatural nature of God's word and that God is ultimately in control. Satan is on a leash. God is only allowing Satan to do certain things at a certain time. God is still all powerful and in control, but he's letting some slack out on the leash of Satan to allow him to do what he's doing. God doesn't agree with evil. He's not the author of evil, but God has allowed these things, some of them, to occur. We live in a sinful, fallen world. This is not what he planned. He planned the Garden of Eden, and sin entered in through one man, Adam. And because of the sin of one man, it's infected all of us, original sin. This wasn't God's original plan. We live in a sinful, fallen world, and we're not robots, and man has a free will, and we can choose to sin all day long. And so God's letting some slack out on the leash, and God, yes, will allow the sinful choices of man to accomplish his ultimate purpose. That doesn't make God the author of evil or the orchestrator of it. He just simply is allowing these things to occur, and many things he has allowed not to occur. He has stopped many things over the time. One of them is he stopped Adolf Hitler, who I believe was the Antichrist for Satan for that generation, because Satan doesn't know when the end of days will be. He has an Antichrist figure, I believe, for every generation. He doesn't know when the end of days will be. That was not God's timing. He stopped it. But one day, he is not going to stop it. He is going to allow it to go ahead and happen, and it will be the fulfillment of Bible prophecy. And I've read the end, you've read the end, and we know how this turns out for those who are called according to his purpose. It all works out for good for us. But the reality is, the New Agers are looking for someone that meets the description of the Antichrist. Well, isn't that interesting? In fact, back in the 1970s, early 80s, there were people that were praying for the Maitreya to come. And then they said, he's actually here among us. Henry Spanks, a prominent man in the common market, so many decades ago said, the world is falling apart financially. We're sinking into an economic morass. The world doesn't need another committee. We have too many committees already. What we need is a man of sufficient stature. A man of sufficient stature to show up on the scene and fix this problem and these problems. And be he God or devil, we will receive him. Reality is, the stage is being set. And here's the interesting part. Many of these people think by the power of their mind, they are helping to orchestrate and bring about the new order, even if that new order means chaos to destroy the sovereignty of nations, the economics of nations, to create chaos and division, and then out of this chaos will come the change. Isn't that what Saul Alinsky said? The change comes from the conflict. Saul Alinsky, the Marxist who dedicated his book in the original to Lucifer, the first rebel known to man who at least earned his own kingdom. The change comes from the conflict. What's Joe Biden's plan called? His plan is called what? Build back better. Build back better. Well, you got to build something back. You got to do what? You got to burn it to the ground. And so for many of them, they want the chaos. James McGregor Burns, a globalist, in his book in 1984 called The Power to Lead, I've quoted it many times to you. He said, the founding fathers have been too smart for us, too shrewd for us. Tinkering and frail bridges won't get the job done. The founding fathers were too smart, too shrewd. We have to revamp the whole system and tear down the Constitution. But the only way we can get the American people to go where we want them to go is through a stupendous political and economic crisis. So they're going to use the crises to get us to go where they want us to go. So you look at all that's happening in the world. Much of it is being orchestrated. It's being set up. It's being allowed to happen, like cranking out trillions and trillions and trillions of dollars, destroying our purchasing power, sending $100 billion plus and counting to Ukraine to protect their borders, where our borders are wide open, bringing in the Marxists and the Islamists to take down the enemies within America, which are those that hold to a Christian worldview, the free market system, private property, and individuality. Because after all, their goal is not going to work if we have individualism. We have to have collectivism, the power of the mind, uniting together with one purpose and one goal, and then collectively through the power of the mind, they believe after they've burned it all down, they can rebuild it into their earthly utopia, heaven on earth. Imagine John Lennon. So yes, I believe one reason they tell us in advance what it is they want to do is because they believe our thinking about it, our talking about it, puts out these messages and this energy into the universe that catches up with everybody else's thoughts and energies and brings about reality. Now, I don't believe that. But that's what the occult teaches in the law of attraction. I think they also believe that somehow they are absolved of any negative thing they do by telling us in advance what it is they're going to do. Here's what you also need to understand. Adolf Hitler had no problem killing the Jews because he believed that he was doing them a favor. You go study Adolf Hitler and the occultism and the New Age concepts of Adolf Hitler and reincarnation and Hinduism mixed with occultism, you will see that Hitler trained his people, his officers, his troops, to understand by slaughtering the Jews, you're doing them a favor because they can come back and be reincarnated in another life and start all over and come back in a better state. So for many of these people, they think what they're doing is actually doing us a favor. Occultism, the New Age.